Today, Vijayadashmi, therefore we will begin our class with Saraswati Stotram. Repeat after me. Ya Kundindu Tushara Hara Dhavalam. या शुभ्रवस्त्रावृता या वीणा वरदंड मंडितकरा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृतिभिः देवैः सदा वन्दिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवतीम् निःशेषजाड्यापहः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् We have completed Tattva Bodha, the basic text for the study of scriptures. Tattva Bodha is the foundation. Having completed that text, we are entering into Bhagavad Gita text. Today I will give you the introduction before starting our text. Every being in this creation want to be free from sorrow, dukkha. In Sanskrit we call it as dukkha nivritti. Free from sorrow. Nivritti means freedom. Dukkha means sorrow. Freedom from sorrow. Every one of us want in our life. It is indirectly asking for ananda prapti. Dukkha nivritti means what? Indirectly I am asking for ananda or sukha prapti. I want to get ananda, sukham. To fulfill this desire alone, to fulfill this desire, what desire? To get ananda in my life, to fulfill that desire, only our scriptures have come forward. First, this is the basic reason why our scriptures have come into forefront. The scripture's purpose is to remove our dukkha and to give us ananda. This is the first point we have to understand, every one of us. Our scriptures in English we call as scriptures, in Sanskrit it is called as Shastram. Shastram. Whatever in Sanskrit we call it as Shastram, that alone they call in English as scriptures. Scriptural literature. The scriptural literature main aim is to give happiness to all beings. All beings, especially human beings mainly. Why the scriptures are called Shastram? The derivation is Shasanat Trayate Iti Shastram. Shas Dhatu. The Shastram word came from the Shas word, the verb. Shas means what? Two meanings are there. Shas means two meanings we can take. One is to control. Better than control, we can say to command better. To command is the one meaning. Second meaning is, Shas means to teach. To teach. Shastram is that Shasanat, by commanding, that which save or that which protects the human life is called Shastram. That's a beautiful derivation. Sanskrit has got a lot of derivations, meaningful. By commanding a human being, it protects the human being. This is the first meaning. The second meaning, by teaching that which protects the human beings by its teaching, in artha. Shastram is that which protects the human beings by its teaching. That is called Shastram. Why two meanings we have to take here? Next point. Shas to command. Shas to teach. Two meanings are relevant for every one of our life. The to command, that meaning initial stages of life of human being from young age. From young age, Shastra commands and protects. Until the person grow and get maturity, Shastra will not teach. Shastra commands. By commanding in the initial stages, it protects the person. Clear? Once the person grow and get little maturity, after the initial stages of life over, little grown up, he is able to or she is able to understand, then Shastra, same Shastra comes and teach. Why it comes to teach? To protect. Like a mother. How mother commands? Young age la, mother commands the child. For what? To protect the child. Later when the child grows, mother teaches. No command, no more command. Teaches. So Shastram is also Sahasra Hitaishini Mata Veda. Shankaracharya says Sahasra Hitaishini Mata. Vedam is that which is equal to 1,000 mothers. 1,000 mothers. This is called Shastram. How beautiful. That Shastram has come in front of us, given by the Lord to protect our life by commandment and teaching. The whole Karmakanda is a commandment, vidhi. பண்ணு. டூ திஸ் டூ திஸ் யூ ஷுட் டூ திஸ் யூ மஸ்ட் டூ திஸ். லேட்டர் சாஸ்திர சேஸ் யூனோ யூ ஆர் ரெடி, தென் சாஸ்திர டீச் யூ த ஹையஸ்ட் ட்ரூத். ஸோ பை தேட் சாஸ்திரா ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் அவர் லைஃப். ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் அவர் லைஃப் மீன்ஸ் இன் வாட் வே? பை கிவிங் ஆனந்தா. துக்க நிவத்தி ஆனந்த பிராப்தி கம்ஸ் பை ஃபாலோயிங் த கமாண்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சாஸ்திர, லேட்டர் பை டீச்சிங் ஆஃப் சாஸ்திர. வை சாஸ்திரா இஸ் ப்ரொடெக்டிங் அஸ்? டு கிவ் ஹாப்பினஸ். ஜஸ்ட் ஆஸ் மதர் ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் த சைல்ட் டு கீப் த சைல்ட் ஹாப்பி, சேம் வே சாஸ்திர ஆல்சோ டஸ் தட். So this is the about Shastram, definition of Shastram. Now this Shastram we can classify into 6 layers. This whole Shastram can be classified into 6 layers or 6 groups. All 6 groups meant to command or to teach according to the level of the seeker. 6 layers. Now one layer I am going to explain, give the name and explain. Then where Bhagavad Gita comes you can understand. This is like a bird eye view. What is Shastram? Now we are entering into the first layer of Shastram, that is Shruti. The entire scriptural literature is called first in the Shruti form. Why it is called Shruti? Shrutatvat Shrutihi. Shrutatvat Shrutihi. Shrutatvat means because it is heard by our rishis. The Shastra is heard by our rishis. That is why it is called Shruti. Shruti anna sangeetam vikrara anda shruti kadaiyadu. Shrotram anna shrotra indriyathukku sambandhamanadhu shruti. Karana paramparaya our rishis received that Veda through their ears. No notebooks, no cassettes, no writing, no pen. Only Karana Paramparaya. Shrutatvat. What they heard? They heard, first Shruti we can divide into 4. Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvana Veda. This is the first group. In the first group of our scriptures, there are 4 Vedas. Rig Veda is a metrical form of Veda, where there are lot of poems, poetical order. That is called Rig Veda. Rig Mantras. The mantra which is in a metrical form is called Rig Mantra. Nearly 20,000, more than 20,000 mantras are there. Available. There are many. Now available 20,000 mantras. Because all we have lost so many mantras. Then the second Yajurveda, nearly 5,000 mantras in the prose form. In the prose form, that is called Yajurveda. All are chantable. Even prose also you can chant, poetry, the metrical form mantras also you can chant. Because it has got a swara, intonation. These mantras has got intonation, swara. So you can chant, chantable. because they are chantable, you are able to remember. Just as you remember the kirtanas, kritis, all you remember because they are able, we are able to chant them. That's why you can remember. Then Samaveda, the third one is Samaveda, consisting of Sama mantras, which are in musical form. Rigveda mantras only in musical form, they are called Sama mantras. Sama Ganam. Devi is Sama Gana Lolni. No? She likes Sama Ganam. No, that is called Samaveda. Then the fourth and final one is Atharvana Veda. Atharvana Veda. It is also consisting of mantras. These mantras especially received by that Angiras Maharshi, Atharva Maharshi. Atharva or Atharvana Maharshi. Therefore, this Veda is called Atharvana Veda. Came from Angiras and Atharvana Rishi. They are called Atharvana Veda. Now, this Veda means what is the meaning? Next, these four Vedas put together come under Shruti. Why Rishis alone heard that mantras? Why not mean? For that, I used to give an example. The TV has got a capacity to receive. Even the programs are all going all over. The waves are there in that. You know, in the waves, they are there in the sound form. When the TV mission has got a capacity to receive, it produces the picture and the sound. Radio has no that capacity, no? It doesn't have that capacity. It cannot reveal that. Similarly, our minds are also not up to the mark. Very pure minds, tapasvis only can receive the mantras. Therefore, receivati iti rishihi. The one who receives mantras is called rishihi. What we receive, what they have given, we are receiving. At least we do that. It is a great contribution to our culture. We need not receive from Akasha. Our rishis have received, we are receiving from them. That's what you are all doing now. You are receiving, you know, indirectly, you know, from our rishis, we are receiving. So Veda means Vedana Sadhanatvat Vedaha. Vedana Sadhanatvat. Or Pramana Janyatvat Veda. Vedana Sadhana means, Sadhana means a means to know. Sadhanam means, Veda. Vedana Sadhana. Vedana means what? Not Tamil Vedana. Vedana means to know. By which means you get knowledge is called Veda. Vidyate anena iti Vedaha. By which you know. What you know, that is we are going to see later. This is the meaning of the Veda. Shruyate iti shrutihi Vedana sadhanatvat Vedaha. Therefore, this it is not written, but it is a apaurusheyam. Not from any human intellect they came, but they are all God's revelations. They are all God's revelations, came from the Lord directly. The shvasa from Brahma is Brahmaji's shvasa when the Vedas came. You know, from Brahmaji's what you can call exhalation. Breathe out. From that breathe out all his mantras came. Imagine. Huh? From that, this first classification this is. So therefore, next one, this is apaurusheyam. Paurusheyam means purusha buddhi moolama, whatever you know through intellect is called paurusheyam. These are very technical terms we have to understand. Paurusheyam means that which you receive through your intellect, no? Receive through intellect or invent through your intellect is purusha buddhi. No? Purusha buddhi means called paurusheyam. But these Vedas are not invented by any human intellect. They are not invented by any human intellect. Therefore, they are called na paurusheyam, apaurusheyam. They are called apaurusheyam. Not born out of any human intellect. Another name for Shastram, this apaurusheya, Vedas, they call it as pramanam. We are going to use that word very, you know, fluently. We use many times that pramanam, Shastra pramanam. What is the pramanam? Means a source of knowledge. A source of knowledge. That is called pramanam. Since our culture is based on this pramanam, Shastram, Veda, our culture, whole culture is based on this Shastram or Pramanam or Apaurusheya Vedas, our culture is called Vedic culture. Now, you know, Vaidika means who is Vaidika? Who is taking the Vedic culture which came from Vedas? Who is taking or following the Vedic culture? Which culture born out of Vedas is called Vedic culture. In Sanskrit, we can call that person who follow the Vedic culture is called Vaidika. We are all Vaidikas. Actually, all Hindus are Vaidikas. Angenge konja nastikas, they are increasing. That is the beauty of our Shastra. Our Shastra, like other religions, never command, never punish. Our Shastra will never command, never punish. If you don't follow Vedic culture, I will punish you, I will ban you, I will, no. Your end of life and epitula. If you want to follow, you follow. Even on the other hand, even people are criticizing also, blaming also, Shastra not saying anything. Shastra expects one day this person will mature, will grow, he will understand. That's why in this culture, we never sentence the person if he go against to the Veda. If you go to other religions, if they go against to the Bible, if they propagate anything against Bible, that person is finished, that's all. They can't survive. Even in Islam, even Christianity, you see, if they go against their Bible or that Quran, that person cannot survive. He will die, that's all. They will kill that person. In this culture only, in Hindu dharma only, Vaidika dharma, Shastra allows the person to grow. Either this janma or next janma, he will come. That's why we give tremendous freedom in this culture. We never punish like that. Our scriptures never accept such a type of punishment, sentencing the person. If you don't accept, because he's having freedom, freedom of thinking. By this you can understand how great Veda is. How great Veda is. So this is about Shruti, first group over. Now the second group, that is Sutra. And the second layer of this, Pramanam or scriptural literature is called Sutra. So from Sutra onwards, number 2, 3, 4, 5, all are Paurusheya. Paurusheya. Born out of human intellect. Born out of human intellect. And another important point we have to note, based on Apaurusheya content. Based on Apaurusheya content Vedas, all other five groups have come into existence. Why they have come? Why? First thing, for codification, number one. Codification. Sutra means codification. Sutra means a thread. Sutra means what? Thread. And in the thread, one sutra, the content is one like one flower. The flower is taken from the Veda. From Apaurusheya Veda, they have taken the content. Each content is like a flower. No? One content of that is a flower. That is a thread. Sutra is the thread. That means what? In the sutra thila irukkira vishayam enna na, Vedathila irukkira pushpangal enna artham. And the Vedathila irukkira vishayam da pushpam madri in the sutra thila, the codified. In a nutshell, in a capsule form. What for? For clarification. If Veda is not very clear to me, it is not very, very clear to me, to clarify that Veda mantras, the sutras have come into existence. All written by great rishis. Yajnavalkya, not Yajnavalkya, the sutras, Apastambha Sutra, great Maharshis have written, Grihya Sutra. Grihya Sutras are those sutras which talk about the family. How to live a householder. No? What is his duties? You have to study Grihya Sutras. How many Grihasthas knows nowadays? The sutra manu irukkane theriyadu. Mangala sutra da theriyum thavara. Vera sutra me theriyadu. That is sutra. This is the little cryptic statement. Sutra manna cryptic statement. It contains a lot of ideas of Vedas. These are all you have to preserve, not just listening nowadays. No? You have to write notes and you have to keep for your next generations. You know, party in the notes of the century. Your grandchildren has to read your notes. That like that only you can communicate this. You keep all this treasure you are giving to your grandchildren. Great-great-grandchildren also it may reach. That's why I ask you write notes, and not for my sake. That is there. And the capsule form and the codified form, it is there. Then, this is also based on the topics. The sutras are also based on topics. What topics? There are different topics. Dharma sutras, mainly Dharma sutras. Responsibilities or duties. Dharma means duties. Family values. One's responsibility in the society as a citizen, as a householder. All levels, as a bachelor, as a grihastha, as a sannyasi, what is my duty? These are all available in the sutras. Where from they have taken? From Vedas. So this is called sutran. That means sutras are those literature which solve the contradiction which is there in Vedas. Apaurusheya, direct Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharvana Veda, all these Vedas, if there is any seeming contradiction, That contradiction is solved in the sutras. Suppose even there is contradiction in sutras also, there is further group. It has come. So this is about sutranam. Codified plus clarified, we can say. Now the next topic is Smriti, the third layer of literature, scriptural literature is Smriti. Smriti. They are all in the form of poems. Smriti. They are also in the form of poem. Smaryate. That means what? This Smriti literature written by our great rishis by remembering the Veda mantras and sutras. This is also Paurusheyam. Came from human intellect. But the content is Veda. That point you have to remember all the time throughout the lecture. Don't think some jobless rishis, sannyasis have given this. They don't have any work. Therefore, they have written simply sitting and... Not like that. Just they remembered that Veda mantras. To clarify that, they brought into it by remembering. And they have written the content in a different format. That's all. Content is same. That is Smritina. They have gathered from the Shruti and Sutra. So Smriti is nothing but the content of Shruti or Sutra. This classification, they talk about the cosmology. Smriti talk about the creation. How the creation arose. Goals of life, Chaturvidha Purusharthas, all mentioned very clearly in Smritis, which are said in Veda. You cannot search where Grihastha Ashrama, Brahmacharya Ashrama. No, they have taken, these rishis have taken that goals of life, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, Chaturvidha Purusharthas is one topic, values. How, what are the duties of a male, Purusha? What is that? What are the duties of a stree, female? What are the duties of a bachelor, Grihastha, Sannyasi, Vanaprastha? Everything they dealt in that. Padikkanum, avladha, namakku theriyadhu, adhula irukku, ellame. That's why olden days people are always studying a lot about scriptures they used to know. நமக்கு இப்போ சர்வைவலே பெரிய ப்ராப்ளம் ஆச்சு. மார்னிங் டு டில் நைட் ஃபார் தி ஸ்மால் ஸ்டமக் சேக் வி ஆர் ஸ்ட்ரைவிங். நவ் தோஸ் டேஸ் பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ டேக்கன் கேர் ஆஃப் தேர் பேசிக் நீட்ஸ் அண்ட் தே ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், தே ஆல்சோ டேக்கன் கேர் ஆஃப் தேர் பேசிக் நீட்ஸ் அண்ட் தே ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட். வி ஆர் ஆல்சோ டூயிங் சேம் திங், டேக்கிங் கேர் ஆஃப் பேசிக் நீட்ஸ், பட் வி ஆர் நாட் ஸ்டடிங். வை? வி வாண்ட் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா. We want extra, more than basic needs. Materialistic life more. That's why we are not studying. Otherwise, we have definitely time to study. That box is morning onwards, 6 o'clock, 5:30 onwards, it is on. Up to next day morning. What is that box? I need not tell the name. That idiot box. TV. That is all the time, switch on, switch on, switch on. Inge time irukka shastram padikkiradhukku. Entertainments. Those days for our rishis, entertainment is studying shastra is the entertainment. Nothing else. That's why they have lived happily. We have left that study, we are suffering nowadays. All problems we are facing. So therefore, the Smriti is more wider than sutras. More wider, more clarified than sutras. Where there are doubts, controversies in sutra, the Smriti has come. Manusmriti, for example, याज्ञवल्क्य स्मृति, ऑल दिस आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्मृतीस, मनुस्मृतीस, थाउजेंड्स थाउजेंड्स ऑफ श्लोकास, वन्ना रुंडा. நமக்கு ஒரு ஸ்லோகம் வாயில தெரிஞ்சு சொல்றது கஷ்டமா இருக்கு. தௌசண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் தௌசண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்லோகாஸ் தே ஹவ் ரிட்டன். ஃபார்ச்சுனேட்லி தட் புக்ஸ் ஆர் அவைலபிள் டில் டுடே. மகா புண்ணியாத்மாஸ் தேர் பிரிண்டிங், சம் பேட்ரன்ஸ் தேர் பிரிண்டிங் த புக்ஸ். மனுஸ்மிருதி டெல்ஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி வாட் இஸ் பிராமண லட்சணம், வாட் இஸ் க்ஷத்ரிய லட்சணம், வாட் இஸ் வைஷ்ய லட்சணம், வாட் தே ஹாவ் டு டூ, ஹவு டு பிஹேவ், ஆல் தே செட் பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி. So this is about Smriti. Next, what number? Fourth. Fourth layer of the teaching, scriptural literature, is Puranas. Puranas. Now many people come to study Shastra, no? And the Varuna Devata also so happy. You know? So happy. You can close if water is falling. No, close. So Puranas, the further expansion matter, then Sutras, then Smriti, further clarification, further magnification, clarification and magnification. Purana means Pura api navaha iti Puranaha. Pura api navaha Puranaha. Pura means ancient, that which is ancient. Purana is also what? Content of Vedas. Content of Vedas. Ancient but not obsolete. Not obsolete means what? It is not outdated. People, they say, no, alla Purana kalathil avan, alla Purana kalam, alla Purana solranna outdated en artham. And the Navaha you have to understand. Pura api Navaha. Ever fresh. That's why till today you would see the Mahabharata. How many times you have seen? You will see any language. Whatever may be the language. I don't bother. But I want to see. How it is Navaha. New. Ever new. New brand. All Puranas are new brand. But Mahabharata won't come under Purana. Ashtadasha Puranas. Kurma Purana, Kartika Purana, Agni Purana, Vishnu Purana, Shiva Purana. Bhagavata Purana is very very popular now. No? Many many Puranas. Vyasa Bhagavan wrote all Puranas. Vyasa Bhagavan wrote all Puranas. He only codified the Vedas. That's why Vedavyasa. Vyasa per enna? Vedavyasa. Avara avvala codified pannadukapparam kuda Veda mantras, he is not happy. He want to bring that whole essence of Vedas into Puranas. Therefore, Pura api Navaha iti Puranaha. That means the abstract teaching of Vedas, which is very difficult to grasp, he picturized in concrete form. Suppose in Taittiriya Upanishad, Krishna Yajurveda, there is one word, Satyam Vada Dharmanchara. In the Satyam Vada, our Harichandra Upakhyanam, it comes. Harichandra, the whole Satyam Vada value picturized in the character of Harishchandra. What a beautiful, no? That's why till today people, if they see the Satya Harishchandra Natakam, they will cry. Till today, if you go to villages, throughout night they would put, I used to see, throughout night, one Harishchandra cannot act throughout night, no? Four, five Harishchandras will come. First scene la or Harichandra, second scene varaku, third scene la or Harichandra. Very difficult. The characterized, picturized, concrete Satyam Vada, that abstract Satyam Vada value concretized in the character. So that to follow that value. Similarly, Rama. Rama character also value, Dharma. It's picturized. रामो विग्रहवान धर्म धर्मम चरा என்ன தர்மம்னா எப்படி புரியும்னா ராமஸ்ய அயனம் இட் கம்ஸ் இன் நெக்ஸ்ட் லேயர் ஆஃப் தட் குரூப் இன் திஸ் புராண இட் இஸ் அன் ஆல்சோ ஈவன் காம க்ரோத லோப மோக மத மாத்சரி ஆல் விச் ஆர் செட் இன் வேதாஸ் தேர் ஆல்சோ பிக்சரைஸ்ட் ஆஸ் சண்ட முண்ட கும் சும்ப நிஷும்ப ஹிரண்யகசிபு ஹிரண்யாட்ச Dantavaktra Shishupala. Who is, where is Dantavaktra Shishupala? Whether these are true or not, fiction, we don't bother. People are doing lot of research. Idella nadandada illiya namak adipatti. Even some people say Sita born to Ravana. There are some historians, they say Sita born to Ravana. We don't bother. Sita born to Ravana or Janaka, who bother? But we bother about dharma. We bother about the values. We bother about that Rama's life. That is, we are interested, not any stories. Unfortunately, people are taking those things as stories and missing the value. Who is the loser? Why unnecessarily you are bothering about history? Take the content. So this is about Purana. This is Tyaga, Prema, all Karuna, all picturized in Devas. Puranas, ellame Devas. Bhagavata Purana, Ashtadasha Puranas are all commander. What? Fourth layer of scriptural literature. What is the content? Veda. Even though they are born from human intellect, based on Veda. That's why any person bring anything out from by writing, we have to see. This book written by that person with ideas, those ideas are from Veda or not. If they are out of Veda, give up immediately, like hot potato. Don't touch them. Dangerous. That's it. Till today they are surviving because of Veda based. The next fifth layer is Itihasa. Itihasa. Iti means in this way. Iti means thus, in this way. In this way means what? Ha means definitely. You know. In this way, ha means definitely. Iti ha asa. It is happened. It is happened or occurred. Mahabharatam, Ramayanam, Prathama Kavyam, Adi Kavyam, Ramayanam. It happened. Rama's life, Ramasya Ayanam, Ramayanam. Rama's way of life is called Rama, Ramayanam. That is called Ramayanam and Mahabharatam is Itihasa. Pandavas, Kauravas, it's happened. Just till today you go and see the Nasik, why it has got name Nasik. Na? And the Surpana kuda nose cut from Nasik. Nasa means nose. That's why it is called Nasik. We all went to Kurukshetra also. Many of you came there. Kurukshetra is a place where this Mahabharata Yuddha taken place. Kurukshetra, till today people are taking that place is a dharma kshetram. Kurukshetra is a dharma kshetram. So they are called itihasa. It happened. That's why they have shown to us, you know, here Bhishma Ampasaya, this is the place where, you know, Duryodhana hide, in which place. They are shown to us. Where all of them taken bath, that sarovaram, all places they have shown. Iti hasa. Does it happen? They have shown to us. Kurukshetrala. Hastinapuram. In the Delhi, another name, Hastinapuram. So these are all, again, that abstract form, which is not very clear in Puranas, which is not very clear in Smriti or Sutras, again magnified and clarified. Clarification and magnification. More magnification. See, How many characters? That's why you like Mahabharatam Panchamo Vedahana. Why it has got a Panchama Veda status? Because the essence of Mahabharata is Veda. Nothing else. So Mahabharata, Ramayana, Bhagavatam, in every house it must be there. If you are not having, go buy immediately tomorrow. Today Vijayadashmi, it's raining. Otherwise, today I will ask you. Tomorrow you go and buy, if you are not having, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Bhagavatam must in our house. We have to keep. Now this is about Itihasa. Then the last and final one, Bhashyam, commentaries. Another interesting point from Ramayana. Ramayana, just as we say, Rama is an embodiment of Dharma. Ravana is an embodiment of multiple personality. 10 heads, no? Any person who is having a split personality, multiple personality, 10 heads eppadi equal varu paarunga. Inga oruthala, indha pakkam 5, indha pakkam 4. Appo enna agum, indha pakkam imbalance. Illaya? That's why Ravana is, even though he is a Shiva Bhakta, great Shiva Bhakta, eppame tug of war in his mind. Very struggle. So that personality tells. Human minds represents Ravana. No, I don't imagine Ravana is somewhere. Namma manasu kulliye. And the multiple personality irundana Ravana arnardam. எங்கெங்க காமம் குரோதம் இருந்தாலும் அந்த ராட்சசர் இருக்கார் நமக்குள்ளேன்னு அர்த்தம். ஸோ அந்த அம்மாள் பூஜை எதுக்கு பண்ணிட்டோம் இன்னைக்கு? துர்கா தேவன் அம்மா, வாட் எவர் அசுர குணாஸ் ஆர் தேர் இன் மீ, ப்ளீஸ் டெஸ்ட்ராய், கிவ் ஞான ஜோதி டு மீ. எதுக்காக சரஸ்வதி பூஜை வீடிட், லக்ஷ்மி பூஜை வீடிட், துர்கா பூஜை, வாட் ஃபர்? ஞானசக்தி, இச்சாசக்தி, கிரியாசக்தி நல்லா வரணும். என்னிடல இருக்கிற அசுர சக்தி எல்லாம் போகணும்னு. தெய்வீ சக்தி வரணும். தெய்வீ சக்தி வந்தாதான் சத்துவகுணம் வரும். சத்துவகுணம் வந்தாதான் அஜ்ஞானம் போகும். தேர்ஃபோர் வி ஆர் வர்ஷிப்பிங் தி தேவி. அந்த துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோ சொன்னாலே பயம் எல்லாருக்குமே. துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோயே வைக்கிறது இல்லை வீட்டில். அதுக்கு தான் எல்லா வீட்டில் நோய் ப்ராப்ளம் எல்லாமே, முதுகு வலி, முட்டி வலி, தலைவலி. ஐ என்க்வைர்ட் இன் மெனி பிளேசஸ், ஹூ இஸ் ஹேவிங் துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோன்னா, நோ சுவாமினி, நோ துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோ, வச்சுக்க மாட்டாங்க வீட்டிலன்னா. ஐ ஸ்டண்ட், ஏன் துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோ ஏன் வச்சுக்க கூடாது? ரௌத்ரமா? ஏதோ இந்த இந்த அம்மா கிட்ட ரௌத்ரம் இல்லாதனால அந்த அம்மா கிட்ட ஏதோ ரௌத்ரம் இருக்கிற மாதிரி. ஏற்கனவே கோபக்காரி இந்த அம்மா. ஏன் ரௌத்ரம் இல்லையா இப்போ? துர்காதேவி வச்சுன்னா வருமா? புதுசா வர வேண்டியது இருக்கு. ஏற்கனவே துர்காதேவி வச்சு சக்தி வரும், ஆரோக்கியம் வரும். திஸ் ஆர் ஆல் லாட் ஆஃப் மிஸ்கன்செப்ஷன்ஸ். So a lot of misconceptions we have to come out. Lakshmi Devan sonna buda 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 kondu vandirukku. Ellar bring the photos. Lakshmi Devi, Saraswati Devi also okay. Some people are having. Adhu enna Lakshmi Devan buda 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 coins ella falling. I will tell you, if you have Lakshmi Devi without Shakti Di, what for this money? If you have Lakshmi Devi without Saraswati, Akshana Mukka Thiriyadu, Vahilandu Varadu. Yedukki inda Lakshmi Pandi enna panna paral? Adhanala vechya Durga Devi, Lakshmi, Saraswati, moonu vechuvomo. Important. Noye varadu pakkathula. Andha Durga Devi irundha aarogyam, shakti. Shakti enna, namakkulla shakti venuma vendama? Ippa inda roadla neenga nadakkuradhukku evlo shakti? Evlo shakti venum? சக்தி ஸ்வரூபிணி என்னன்னா, ட்ரை டு ப்ளீஸ் கீப் தட் துர்காதேவி ஃபோட்டோ. ஓகே, நவ் வில் கம் டு பாஷ்யம். பாஷ்யம் இஸ் தட் த கமெண்டரிஸ் ரிட்டன் பை ஆல் ஆச்சாரியாஸ். த மோர் எலாபரேட் ஃபார்ம் த கண்டென்ட் ஆஃப் வேதாஸ், வாட் எவர் செட் இன் சூத்ரா, வாட் எவர் செட் இன் புராணாஸ், வாட் எவர் said in Smriti, whatever said in Itihasa, all codified in Bhashyam. they brought into Bhashyam. Shankaracharya quotes many Vishnu Sahasranama, and he quotes so many. In his Bhashyam, he quotes Puranas. Vishnu Puranam, he quotes often. Many places he quotes. So the Bhashyams written also in Sanskrit. That is another thing. All are in Sanskrit. In the Vartha Sholala. All the six groups, six layers of our literature, all are in Sanskrit. Deva Bhasha, Girvana Bhasha, Daiva Bhasha. From that Sanskrit only all came. How this Kambaramayanam came in Tamil? Who wrote Kambaramayanam? Valmiki ani solladunga. Who wrote Kambaramayanam? Enna periya kelvi paarunga. Kambar. Kambaramayanam, Kambar. Valmiki Ramayanam, who wrote ana? Somebody said Vyada Vyasarana. One class I asked, who wrote Valmiki Ramayanam na? Vyasa Bhagavan wrote ana. I have to shake my head, no? What happening in Valmiki Ramayana written by Valmiki. So we are in which condition, imagine. Na? Yaar enna eludhunadhe theriyamale irukana, where the question of reading. Adhe enna enak interest illa nu solla. Idhula interest ku enna vishayam irukappa adhula. You want ananda, adhu dhaan main thing. Okay. Ananda prapti dukkha nivrutti. Adhukaga indha commentaries. Indha commentary ku sub-commentaries. And the sub-commentaries, sub-sub-commentaries. Now, the Bhashyams are also available. Shankaracharya wrote Bhashyam for 10 Upanishads and Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sutra. Brahma Sutra belongs to that Sutra, literature. And Bhagavad Gita belongs to Smriti, Smriti Grandha, content of Upanishad. Content of Veda. Upanishad is the content of Veda. Veda alone is in the Upanishad. Upanishad alone is in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is in occurring in Mahabharata, Itihasa. We have landed now to Bhagavad Gita. What text we are going to study? Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Upanishatsu, Brahma Vidyayam, Yoga Shastre, Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade. Where the Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvada taken place in Mahabharata? Mahabharata is a itihasa. In that, the Vedic teaching, Lord Krishna brought and taught to Arjuna. Now, understand? What Lord Krishna taught to Arjuna is nothing but Veda. In a simple form. Why? This is Itihasa. That is Veda. Very difficult. Abstract form. I have to concretize. Chinna chinna padama chulli. Very very simple way. Karma Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga. All Krishna Paramatma talks, even about food, he talks simple way. 700 verses are there in Bhagavad Gita. Ramayanam is 24,000 verses. Balakanda nindu start panni last varuk. Uttara Ramayana varuku povana 24,000 verses. Whereas this Mahabharata 1 lakh verses. Imagine panna mudiyadhu 1 lakh. There is a nice word. Dharmascha arthascha mokshascha bharatarshabha yadi iha asti yanneha asti karhichitu. Now, whatever is said in Mahabharata, dharma is talked about, artha, how to earn money, talked about, and dharma, artha, moksha. This is Bhagavad Gita, the moksha shastram. It comes in Bhagavad Gita only, Mahabharata only. हे भरतर्षभा, हे अर्जुना, यत इह अस्ति, वाट एवर इज सेड इन महाभारत इज देर एवरीवेयर. यदि इह अस्ति महाभारते, तदेव सर्वत्र अस्ति. वाट एवर इज सेड इन महाभारत अलोन इज देर एवरीवेयर. यदि इह अस्ति, यदि इह न अस्ति, वाट एवर इज नॉट देर इन भारत इज नॉट देर आउटसाइड. See the presentation of the shloka. What is there alone in Mahabharata is there everywhere. What is not there in Mahabharata is not there anywhere. Enna ardham? Ulagathilo enna irukko, enna maadhiri manasthathvangal ella irukko, enna problems ella irukko, adellame Mahabharathathula irukke. Adukku da swami na Mahabharata padikkirade illa. Another misconception. And brothers, in between brothers, there are a lot of fight. So therefore, don't keep Mahabharata, Krishna Upadesham koda, don't keep. Durga Devi also, they don't keep. Gita Upadesham also, they don't keep. And Sanda Varuma, brothers middle. Erkkarave irikka Sanda. And Gita Upadesham illamale koda irikka Sanda. Not because of that. No? If you read properly, the Pandavas, how they lived, no? And the Sanda poido. Priyada, so this Mahabharata is the essence of Vedas. Now you understand six groups of these layers. What is the first one? Shruti. Number two, Sutra. Number three, Smriti. Number four, Puranas. Number five, Itihasa. Number six, Bhashyam. So all these six are nothing but content of Veda. What a contribution done by our rishis. Is it not our responsibility to look into them? To study? What for? For whose sake they are? Day and night they have done lot of tapas and they have written and they have given to us. Once in a week vandu namma padika kudada Bhagavad Gita. எதுக்காக ஆனந்த பிராப்தியர்த்தம், துக்க நிவர்த்தியர்த்தம், டு பி ஃப்ரீ ஃப்ரம் சாரோ, டு கெட் ஆனந்த மோக்ஷா. தட்ஸ் வை பகவத்கீதா இஸ் கால்ட் மோக்ஷாஸ்திரம். மோக்ஷாஸ்திரம், மோக்ஷா மீன்ஸ் வாட்? ஃப்ரீடம். ஃப்ரீடம் ஃப்ரம் வாட்? ஃப்ரீடம் ஃப்ரம் சாரோ. ட்ரை டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு பி ஃப்ரீ ஃப்ரம் சாரோ, ஸ்டடி பகவத்கீதா. Then further, after studying Gita, then you are mature, then you can study Upanishads. More mature, study Brahma Sutra. Then you become a pakka anando Brahma Asmi. Brahma Swarupam is anandam. Aham Brahma Asmi, that ananda Swarupam I am. Adi chollenu in the life lo. Human life is meant to own up this alone. Try to understand. I am born as a human being to get this Aham Brahmasmi Jnanam, to own up, to claim I am Ananda Swarupaha, I am Brahma Swarupaha. There is no doubt in this, this is the fact. That's why own up your Ananda nature by studying Bhagavad Gita. Next class onwards, we will start and I conclude with this. The malanirmochanam pumsam Gita snanam bhasim. Na Gita and ambhasin and the water la Gita and ambhasi water la snanam pannanuma. Enna aguna malanirmochanam aayidum. Malam poyidum. Impurity will go. Paapam ellame poyidum. Paapam pona enna varum? Punyam. And the punyam mulama namakku gnanam kadaikum. That's why on this auspicious day, Vijayadashmi day, we are starting whatever you start. For which sankalpa? All of you do sankalpa. I want to get moksha. Manasalo nerchukongo. I want to get moksha. Atma jnanam. Whatever sankalpa you take, you will get success in this life itself. That is the significance of this auspicious day. That's why we are starting today. Okay? We will conclude with this. Afterwards, विल चैंट दट गीता फर्स्ट श्लोक एंड विल स्टॉप. ओम पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि.